First asset resolution by setting up a new structure. The high level of provisioning by public sector banks of their stressed assets calls for a measure to clean up the bank books. An asset reconstruction company limited, an asset management company would be set up to consolidate and take over the existing stressed debt and then manage and dispose of the assets to alternative investment funds and other potential investors for eventual value realization. Recapitalization of PSB. To further consolidate the financial capital capacity of PSBs, further recapitalization of 20,000 crores is proposed in 21-22. Deposit insurance. Last year, government had approved an increase in the deposit insurance cover from 1 lakh rupees to 5 lakhs for bank customers. I shall be moving amendments to DICGC Act 1961 in this session itself to streamline the provision so that if a bank is temporarily unable to fulfill its obligations, the depositors of such bank can get easy and time-bound access to their deposits to the extent of the deposit insurance cover. This would help depositors of banks that are currently under stress. To improve credit discipline, while continuing to protect the interests of small borrowers, for NBFCs with minimum asset size of 100 crores, the minimum loan size eligible for debt recovery under the securitization and reconstruction of financial assets and enforcement of security interests, SARFAESI Act 2002, it is proposed to be reduced from the existing level of 50 lakhs to 20 lakhs. Company matters. The decriminalization of the procedural and technical compoundable offences under Companies Act 2013 is now complete. I now propose to take up decriminalization of the Limited Liability Partnerships Act 2008. Honourable Speaker, I propose to revise the definition under the Companies Act 2013 for small companies by increasing the threshold for paid up capital from not exceeding 50 lakh to not exceeding 2 crores and turnover from not exceeding 2 crores to not exceeding 20 crores. This will benefit more than 2 lakh companies in easing their compliance requirements. As a further measure which directly benefits startups and innovators, I propose to incentivize the incorporation of one-person companies by allowing one-person companies to grow without any restriction on paid-up capital and turnover, allowing their conversion into any other type of company at any time, reducing the residency limit for an Indian citizen to set up an one-person company from 182 days to 120 days, and allow also non-resident Indians to incorporate OPCs in India. This will be a big boost for startups. To ensure faster resolution of cases, the NCLT framework will be strengthened, e-court system shall be implemented, and alternate methods of debt resolution and special framework for MSMEs shall be introduced. During the coming fiscal, we will be launching data analytics, artificial intelligence, machine learning, driven MCA 2.1 version to MCA 21 version 3.0, MCA 21 version 3.0. This version 3.0 will have additional modules for e-scrutiny, e-adjudication, e-consultation, and compliance management. Disinvestment and strategic sale. In spite of COVID-19, we have kept working towards strategic disinvestment. A number of transactions, namely BPCL, Air India, Shipping Corporation of India, Container Corporation of India, IDBI Bank, Bharat Earth Movers Limited, Pavan Hans, Neelachal Ispat Nigam Limited, among others, would be completed in 21-22. Other than IDBI Bank, we propose to take up the two public sector banks and one general insurance company in the year 21-22. This would require legislative amendments, and I propose to introduce the amendments in this session itself. In 21-22, we would also bring the IPO of LIC, for which I am bringing the requisite amendments in this session itself. In the Atmanirbhar package, I had announced that we will come out with a policy of strategic disinvestment of public sector enterprises. I'm happy to inform the House that the government has approved the said policy. The policy provides a clear roadmap for disinvestment in all non-strategic and strategic sectors. We have kept four areas that are strategic, where bare minimum CPSEs will be maintained and rest privatized. In the remaining sectors of all CPSEs will be privatized. The main highlights of the policy are mentioned in Annexure 3. To fast forward the disinvestment policy, I'm asking NITI to work out on the next list of center public sector companies that would be taken up for strategic disinvestment. To similarly incentivize states to take to disinvestment of their public sector companies, we will work out an incentive package of central funds to states. Idle assets will not contribute to Atmanirbhar Bharat. The non-core assets largely consists of surplus land with government ministries and departments and public sector enterprises. Monetizing of land can either be by way of direct sale or concession or by similar means. This requires special abilities, and for this purpose, I propose to use a special purpose vehicle in the form of a company that would carry out this activity. In order to ensure timely completion of closure of sick or loss-making CPSEs, we will introduce a revised mechanism that will ensure timely closure of such units. I have estimated 1,75,000 crores as receipts from disinvestment in BE 21-22.